We're looking forward to January. We are at the end of this month having our 2015 Call for Discernment Conference. That conference is entitled Hope and the Homosexual Agenda, and it's going to be January 23rd through the 25th, 2015. You can find more information at the website hopeintruth.org. We're at Cornerstone Baptist Church, 3370 Snow Hill Road in Chuliota, Florida, 32766. And it's a joy to have on the phone with me Mike Gendron. Mike is going to be our guest speaker for this conference. He's with Proclaiming the Gospel Ministries. How are you doing, Mike?
Well, I'm still blessed and enjoying God's creation and all of the beauty of His majesty and abiding in His Word. It can't get any better than that, Mark.
Amen. Amen. And that's what we want to do, too, with this conference. We're abiding in God's Word. We want to be faithful to God's Word, and we want to present the truth of God's Word to people at this conference, Hope and the Homosexual Agenda. And we're grateful to have you as our featured speaker. And I wanted to ask you, Mike, for our WTLN listeners, those who might be listening in and wanting to know more about what this conference is going to address, you know, often we hear the accusation, if you will, that we tend to focus in on, or in fact, you know, pick on or talk about homosexuality as if it's a sin set apart unto itself. And how would you address those that might say, well, you're just picking on homosexuality, or you're just picking on that particular sin? You know, why would we address this, or why would we do a conference like this? How would you answer that question?
Well, mainly we're addressing the topic of homosexuality is because there are many pastors and denominations that are normalizing same-sex relationships. We now see that 36 states in America are approving gay marriage. And so this is an issue that's not only affecting our culture, but also our church. We have people that call themselves gay Christians, and one of the things I'm going to address in one of my messages is that there are false converts in our churches, and those who think they can be a Christian and also practice homosexuality, they're just false converts. And so there's a special method of reaching false converts. They're either victims of self-deception, hearing God's word but not doing what it says, or they're victims of external deception where people have told them that homosexual relationships are not sinful in the light of, in the eyes of God. And so we have to be careful how we address them. We always have to lead with compassion and love, speaking the truth in love. In fact, one of the messages that I will be doing deals with how we are to approach them. We need to be kind and gentle in correcting those who are in opposition to the truth of God's Word. Of course, Mark, this doesn't mean that we don't contend and fight for the truth with spiritual weapons. We just need to do it the right way, the biblical way. We need to be approachable. We need to be easy to speak to, compassionate and sensitive. We need to avoid being harsh. We need to avoid being abusive or pugnacious, overbearing or contentious. We need to be kind and loving because that's the only way to reach people. People are going to run if we don't speak the truth in love. And of course, this is all only possible if we maintain a humble spirit. We know that that's what God extends grace to, those who are humble. And so we're dealing with very proud people who are aggressively pursuing the homosexual agenda, and we need to let them know that God extends grace to the humble, but He opposes the proud. And so we need to model that. True humility is when our focus is defending the Lord Jesus and His Word and not defending ourselves, because we're going to be attacked. People are going to come at us and say that we're homophobic, and we just need to let that slide off our back and proclaim the Word of God, because in the Word of God is an inherent power to convert the soul and to save people from the power of the sin that actually entraps them, whether it be homosexuality or any other sin that people are involved in. Jesus Christ is the only hope, and so we need to approach the homosexual community for the glory of God and doing it His way and not our way.
Amen. I'm reminded of so many examples that we've seen in the past of professing Christians, maybe a professing church and not a church at all, in fact, that would, like Westboro Baptist, we've seen them on the news confronting this movement in very unbiblical and unloving ways. How do you think that kind of approach to addressing this issue has hurt the cause of Christ or the cause of churches in addressing this agenda?
Well, we need to be Christ-like, and they're definitely not Christ-like. If we read how the Lord Jesus engaged sinners, he did it with great compassion and with love, and Amen. That's what we need to do. You know, when you look at the ministry of our Lord Jesus on this earth, he got in the face of religious leaders that were deceiving people, but he showed great compassion for sinners. And so, Mark, we need to ask ourselves, are we a bridge or a barrier to homosexuals coming to Christ? Are we pointing them to Christ, or are we pushing them away from Christ? And so those are the questions we need to ask. And again, we need to approach people with humble hearts and with great compassion, speaking the truth in love.
Yeah, that brings up a very good point. You know, you mentioned how often the Christian or that loving brother or sister who is trying to bring the love of Christ, the gospel of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, to someone enslaved in that sin, they often get labeled with accusations of homophobia or gay bashing. How might you encourage a Christian, a genuine brother or sister who wants to share the gospel with someone enslaved to that sin, how might you encourage them or exhort them to approach them? How might they answer that accusation of homophobia or gay bashing? How would you help them with that?
Well, I think, again, it comes back to the attitude of our hearts. We shouldn't be intimidated by the aggressive pro-gay culture. We need not to run from our God-given responsibility, and that's to publicly stand for the truth of God's Word. And so no one needs to shrink back just because we're called names. We need to be patient when people are speaking unkindly of us, recognizing there but by the grace of God go I. So that's what part of my message will be in 2 Timothy chapter 2, that we are to be able to teach and patient when wronged. And so we must be forbearing and able to endure mistreatment without retaliating in anger. And that's what the flesh wants to do. And I can say I've been guilty of that in the past, but if we go into each witnessing opportunity equipped with the Word of God, with a humble, lovable spirit, then I think we will draw people to Christ rather than push them away.
Amen. You know, considering our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, who endured such hostility from sinners against himself, you know, following his example to get the gospel out to lost people. So thank you for that very much, brother. We're so looking forward to having you here for our conference. Again, that's Hope and the Homosexual Agenda. It's our 2015 Call for Discernment Conference, January 23rd through the 25th, 2015, at Cornerstone Baptist Church. There's a limited seating, so please register today at hopeintruth.org, or you can call our church offices at 407-971-7685. We look forward to seeing you there, and God bless you.